It's Friday. Welcome to Masterpiece Theater. My name is the Right Reverend Robert Raymond Evans. I'm glad you're here. I should be sitting in that high back chair dressed in a suit to say that, right? On PBS. Have you ever heard the CBC announcers when they're announcing like classical music on a station? That, of course, was the Fifth Movement by Bach here on CBC Radio. Those guys always sound so mellow and unenthusiastic. It's because all they do is listen to classical music. Nothing wrong with that, but you got to get a little bit of rock and roll into your life. You know what I'm saying, right? That's right. Anyway, how you doing? Welcome to Friday. You guys excited? All right. Psalm 124. It's a long weekend. I'm excited. I get Monday off this week with my wife. Woohoo! She had to work today. Usually she gets Fridays off, so it's all good. The days are long, but the years go fast. Okay. I think I need a little more caffeine. Hang on a sec, folks. Be kind. Be kind to each other. All right? Okay. I think we better pray. I'm a little unfocused this morning. You're getting the attention deficit, Bob. Let's pray. Father, for all of us that are gathering today at your word, we pray that it would mean much to our souls. It would get deep inside of us and change our spiritual DNA and make us new, Lord, and make us focus on you. And we thank you that you're here to teach us, Spirit of God. And I pray for your help in that and for all of us, Lord, to understand. Make us who are weak, strong. Make us who are timid, bold. Help us, Lord, to be your people. You are our God. Thank you for being our Father. Thank you for Jesus, your Son, who came down to die for us and forgive our sin and rise from the dead. And we can't wait to see our coming King on the clouds. And we thank you, Lord, for sending the Spirit. And Holy Spirit, we thank you that you're here amongst us. To your glory, we pray. Bless those that are traveling and protect them, we pray, on their way to work. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to Psalm 124. That's pretty cool. On Tuesday morning, when we resume, we're not going to be here Monday. We'll be here Sunday at 9. But Tuesday morning, Psalm 125 will be, Jermico is going to join me, and he's going to teach us Psalm 125. It'll be fun Tuesday morning. But we're on 124 for now. And Pastor David Guzik said, this psalm could be called Thanking God for the Help Only He Can Bring. That's a good name for this psalm. And it starts off with verse 1 very plainly. What if the Lord had not been on our side? Think about that. What if the Lord had not been on our side? What if he left us alone to figure it out? What if God did create the world and then flicked the earth off into space and it was spinning and he's like, okay, I'm done. You guys deal with it. And what if he had not right away after we sinned put his plan in motion to save us? What if we would be done? We'd be done. Let all Israel, let all God's people repeat, what if the Lord had not been on our side when people attacked us? We would have no buffer between us and people. We would have no shield against the fiery darts that enemies of evil, and the evil enemies that we face sometimes launch at us. What would we be doing? How could we survive? We couldn't. It's so simple. What if the Lord had not been on our side? If you want to start to feel your salvation, ask that question. Because if you'd look deep inside, you know, and I know very well, I do not have the wherewithal to be able to handle life. I can't do it. I don't know where I would be without the Lord Jesus during this pandemic. I don't know how people do it. I guess that's why liquor sales have gone through the roof. And, you know, I saw the cannabis store across the street from the hub just get busy when the pandemic hit, because we need something to comfort us, right? And I know that I couldn't live without Jesus. The grave would have swallowed me alive in its burning anger. Verse 3 says, the people, the enemies, would have swallowed us alive in their burning anger. Where would I be without the Lord? What if the Lord had not been on our side? The waters would have engulfed me. A torrent would have overwhelmed me. Yes, the raging waters of their fury would have overwhelmed our very lives. We're flooded every day with good news, aren't we? Right? No, we're flooded with bad news. And, you know, just as you turn a corner on something new, this big flood comes in and it bowls us over like we're bowling pins, right? And the raging waters can hit us hard. It's always a surprise, always a twist and a turn. What if the Lord had not been on our side during the flood? Jesus is the ark. He is the true ark that saves people like us from the flood. When we're on him, it's scary, but we're safe. Verse 6 says, praise the Lord, who did not let their teeth tear us apart. Jesus, I want you to picture John chapter 10, where Jesus says, I am the good shepherd who gives his life for his sheep. The hired hands, they run because they're not the shepherd. They're just the hired hands. And so when it comes to picturing what Jesus did for us, picture the good shepherd and the wolf of death, the wolf of judgment, of wrath, the wolf of condemnation with its teeth bared was facing us down, and we're sheep. We couldn't do anything against this creature, this consequence of our sin, the wrath that we deserve, death, right? Death is the price. That's why the world's so messed up. Death was the price, the Bible says, of our sin. The wages of our sin is death. But Jesus stepped in between, and the teeth of the wolf sank into him, and the good shepherd gave his life for his sheep. And we not only survived, but we were made new by his spirit. So picture that. We escaped like a bird from a hunter's trap. The trap is broken and we are free. What an amazing picture. We were birds that fell for the breadcrumbs that Satan put in front of us. We stepped into the trap and there was no way out. But the trap is broken and we are free. Chuck Swindoll, a long time ago, preached a sermon on a tape, a cassette that I listened to. And it was one of the most pivotal sermons I ever heard. And he said, mankind has been sitting in this cage for 2,000 years and the door's open. All you got to do is get up and walk out. Because Jesus broke the trap. He released the shackles from your feet. The fetters are gone. You're free. And you just got to get up and walk out the door. You don't have to stay stuck. Jesus has made a way for you and me to be free. It's the most beautiful picture. This is the most beautiful line this morning, next to what if the Lord had not been on our side. The trap is broken and we are free. The trap is broken and we are free. The trap of death is defeated, right? Hebrews 2:14 says, because God's children are human beings, were made of mere flesh and blood. The Son of God, Jesus, became flesh and blood, for only as a human being could he die, and by dying could he break the power of the devil who had the power of death. Only in this way could Jesus set free all those who have lived their lives as slaves to the fear of dying. Mankind is terrified of dying. Jesus has set us free from that fear because he defeated death. The trap is broken and we are free. Our help is from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Our help is from the Lord, maker of heaven and earth. Think about that. God, who invented this universe with its nebulae and its comets and its rainbows and its oceans and its volcanoes, its earthquakes and its dolphins and its eagles and its wheat growing in massive fields and grass that covers the earth to feed everything. a planet with a molten core that keeps us warm and a sun that's millions and millions of miles away, but we're in the right spot in the universe not to melt, not to freeze. It's all God, the maker of heaven and earth, all of that. He loves you. He knows your name. Matthew 6, Jesus says, he counts the hairs on your head. That's amazing. He knows that much about you and me. And he loves you and he's going to give you his help. What an amazing promise. We are free. We're free from fear. We're free from sin. We're free from hell. We're free from death. Not even death can take it away from me because I'm free. I want you to listen to the lyrics of this Stephen Curtis Chapman song.
I had an opportunity a few years ago to walk through a prison up in Michigan with a man named Chuck Colson, who is in a large way responsible for what we're doing here tonight. Began the Ministry of Prison Fellowship and Starting Line, which grew out of that. And I met a man walking through a death row cell block. Spent a little time talking to him, and after I left that prison that day, a few months later, I wrote this song about my experience there, and I pray that it'll encourage you guys here, probably more so than anyone else, who can appreciate and identify with the message of this song. The sun was beating down inside. The walls of stone and razor wire, as we made our way across the prison yard. I felt my heart begin to race as we drew nearer to the place where they say that death is waiting in the dark. The slamming doors of iron echoed through the halls, where despair holds life within its cruel claws. But then I met a man whose face it seemed so strangely out of place, a blinding light of hope shining in his eyes. And with repentance in his voice, he told me of his tragic choice that led him to this place where he must pay the price. But then his voice grew strong as he began to tell about the one he said had rescued him from hell. He said, I'm free, yeah, I have been forgiven. God's grace has broken all my chains and given me these wings, and I'm free, yeah. And the freedom I've been given is something that not even death can take away from me, because I'm free. Jesus set me free. So we said a prayer and said goodbye, and tears begin to fill my eyes as I step back out into the blinding sun. And even as I drove away, I found that I cannot escape the way he spoke of what the grace of God had done. I thought about how sin has sentenced all of us to die, and how God gave his only son so you and I could say I'm free, yeah. Oh, I have been forgiven. God's grace has broken all our chains, given us these wings, and we're free, yeah. And the freedom we've been given is something that not even death can take away from me, because I'm free. And if the sun has set you free, oh, if the sun has set you free, then you are really free. You are really free. And if the sun has set you free, oh, if the sun has set you free, then you are free, really, really free. Oh, we're free, yeah. We
something that not even death can take from you and me, because we're free, yeah. The freedom we've been given is something that not even death can take from you and me. No, this is something that not even death can take from you and me. Oh, this is something that not even death can take from you and me. 'Cause Jesus sets us free. And we are free. 'Cause Jesus sets us free. And we are free. Yeah.
Stephen Chris Chapman was singing that in the prison. The trap is broken and we are free. That is good news. And that's why there's hope at 7. Let's pray. Father, fill us with the joy of knowing that we are free in you. Lord, we thank you that you came after us, that you did not leave us alone, you did not leave us trapped. We love you. We pray for that freedom to fill our souls with joy. And that, Lord, we could dispense that kind of grace and peace to the people around us, that, Lord, our friends and family, our co-workers, our fellow students would be free. Jesus, may they know from your grace, gracious spirit through us, through your word, through whatever it takes, Lord, may they know that the trap is broken and we can be free. I love you, Lord. I thank you for this truth. Thank you for your people. Fill them with joy and give them a weekend, Lord, where they are restored in their spirit and their hope and their joy, and may they have a good weekend, Lord, I pray. Amen. Hey, folks, we're at church on Sunday, as usual, and I'd love to see you at church. If you go to aplacetobelong.ca and just click register for church, you can sign up for 9 or 10:30. Please come and enjoy church with God's people. I guess there's good news coming from the province next week. I can't wait for the day when we can have one service, get everybody together, have a good time. God loves you. I will see you Tuesday morning at 7, taking Monday off. But I'll be here 9 a.m. SSC Live Online. If you can't come to church, Jermika will be here with me Tuesday. It'll be great. Love ya. Have a great week.